2011, the year Windows got a glow up. Let's rewind to the early 2010s, a time of rapid tech evolution. Smartphones were blowing minds, the cloud was the talk of the town, and developers on Linux were living the dream with tools like APT and Yum to manage software. And Windows? Oh boy. Windows users were still stuck in the stone age of software installation. Picture this. You needed an app. You Googled for it. You prayed that the download wasn't a malware party in disguise. You clicked next through a maze of options, dodging sketchy toolbars like you were in a bad game of Minesweeper. And then you hoped it worked. It was tedious. It was chaotic. It was frustrating. Enter Rob Reynolds, the hero we didn't know we needed. Now meet Rob Reynolds. He wasn't just a developer. He was a battle-hardened Windows guy who'd spent years in the trenches of system management. He had seen it all, from the minor annoyances to the downright soul-crushing processes of Windows software installs. But here's the twist. Rob was also an automation ninja. He was neck-deep in PowerShell. Yep, that scripting language most people avoided like the plague. And NuGet, Microsoft's package manager for .NET libraries. One day, Rob had a eureka moment. Why not make a package manager for Windows apps? Not just for libraries or scripts, but for full-blown software, Chrome, Git, VLC Media Player, the stuff we use every day. That idea, it became Chocolatey. From crazy idea to working magic, Rob got to work. He knew PowerShell was the key. It was already built into Windows and could automate almost anything if you spoke its language. And instead of building everything from scratch, he piggybacked off NuGet for the back end. By March 2011, Chocolatey was born. Why Chocolatey? Well, NuGet was named after NuGet, the candy, and Rob figured, what's better with NuGet than chocolate? Boom, branding genius. Chocolatey's charm was its simplicity. Installing an app went from an afternoon of headaches to a single command, bash Choco install Google Chrome. That's it. No ads, no toolbars, no drama, just done. The rise of Chocolatey. At first, Chocolatey was a secret weapon for developers and IT pros. Linux users might have scoffed, we've had this for years. But for Windows users, this was a revelation. Devs started using it to set up their environments in minutes instead of hours. Sysadmins realized they could manage entire fleets of machines with a few commands. It wasn't just a time saver, it was a sanity saver. The open source community jumped in, building and maintaining packages for everything under the sun. Git, Node.js, Zoom, VS Code, you name it. By 2014, Chocolatey had grown from a nifty side project into a game changer. Chocolatey for business, the big league move. Rob knew he was onto something big, especially as enterprises began adopting Chocolatey. But businesses needed more. Better security, centralized management, advanced reporting. So Rob launched Chocolatey for Business, C4B, a premium version packed with enterprise features. The strategy? Genius. The free version stayed open source, keeping the community alive and thriving. The business version brought in the funds to fuel development. IT teams couldn't get enough. With Chocolatey, they could roll out software across thousands of machines without breaking a sweat. Why Chocolatey is a big deal. Chocolatey isn't just about faster installs. It's about automation, consistency, and control. Before Chocolatey, setting up a Windows machine was like baking a cake without a recipe. Everyone did it differently, and it often ended in disaster. Chocolatey changed all that. Now, you could script the perfect setup, share it, and watch as every machine followed the same steps flawlessly. It was like having a magic wand for Windows. Imagine switching to a new phone and restoring everything from the cloud. Chocolatey brought that kind of ease and magic to Windows. The community that made it happen. By 2015, Chocolatey had exploded in popularity, and thousands of contributors were maintaining packages, fixing bugs, and pushing updates. Rob wasn't flying solo anymore. The project had become a cornerstone of the Windows developer ecosystem. Even Microsoft couldn't ignore it. By the time they rolled out their own package manager, winget, in 2020, Chocolatey was already a household name, and rather than replace Chocolatey, winget became its sidekick. Today, Chocolatey's sweet success, fast forward to now, and Chocolatey boasts over 10,000 packages and millions of users. From solo developers to global enterprises, it's a staple of the Windows world. And Rob, he's still at the helm, ensuring Chocolatey stays true to its mission while keeping it fresh. The legacy of Chocolatey. Rob Reynolds didn't just create a tool. He sparked a revolution. Chocolatey proved that Windows could be as slick and developer-friendly as Linux or Mac OS. It's not flashy. It doesn't reinvent the wheel. But it works, and it solves a problem we all faced. And that's how one man's frustration turned into a tool that transformed Windows software forever.